What's up everyone, it's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So I wanted to make a quick little video this morning talking about three stocks that I'm seeing opportunities in right now. So smash that like button, let's get into it very quickly. This is going to be a 5-minute video literally, and let's just get right into it. So what's the first one I'm seeing here? This is JNJ, Johnson & Johnson. I did not talk about this one in yesterday's video, even though I said I was going to at the beginning of the video. I got a little bit sidetracked, did not end up getting to it. So Johnson & Johnson, we saw they reported earnings yesterday. They actually beat on earnings per share and on revenue, yet the stock went down. We can see on this closer term chart here, let's go to the, let's say, 20-day, 1-minute chart. The stock went down from 132 all the way down to 127. It seems like it found a support at around 127, 128. Opening up that margin of profit from where we are right now, or where we were at 128, up to around 123 of around a 3.3% margin of profit. So this is actually one of the safer trades that I'm looking to make right now on Johnson & Johnson. We're holding that 180 SMA right now very nicely with around 7 minutes into the market as of the time that I'm recording this video. So let's take a look, guys. If we do end up holding it here, start to push back up, I think we'll be able to fill this gap from at least, you know, up to 131 down to where we are right now. And, you know, my stop loss would be around this support at around 127.80, let's say. And, you know, I think it's a good chance from, you know, 128, 129 up to 131. And, of course, we're going to be watching the trend and see if it slowly starts to close that gap. So that's the one stock I'm watching that it's currently uptrending and slowly starting to reverse, Johnson & Johnson. Another one that I'm watching, guys, is UWT. This is not a stock, this is an ETF, and we talk about this one a lot on the channel. And this is a crude oil based ETF, meaning whenever crude oil is going up in price, UWT is going up in price as well. So let's take a look at crude oil very quickly so we can see my reasoning behind why I like UWT this week. So we can see crude oil has continued the uptrending pattern from the pullback at $44 or $54 all the way down to around $52.20. We bounced on that 180 SMA. We're making higher lows if we're talking about this smaller pattern here from about the 22nd of January from yesterday in the morning. We've been making higher lows, right? What I want to see, though, is that we're getting rejected by the 50 SMA. What I want to see is we break out of that 50 SMA resistance on this 20-day chart, and that's going to be a good sign for me to slowly start building in a position on UWT. So UWT, like I said, goes up whenever crude oil is going up. And if crude oil does end up breaking that SMA resistance, you know, crude oil is going to be bouncing on this 50 SMA resistance, right? Or UWT rather, and it's going to be slowly pushing up. So this could be a potentially nice entry point. And just like UWT, this one's on an uptrending pattern. It's holding a higher low and is currently at a very critical support. If we end up bouncing here, guys, that's going to be a higher low from the previous, and that's going to be a continuation, opening up a nice entry point in UWT. So one more I want to talk about before I do end off this video is going to be JDST. So we're seeing the gold futures right now. They got rejected by the 180 SMA here on the 100 or on the 20-day, 1-hour chart pretty strongly, guys. We're seeing some strong red candlesticks starting to push down, and this could be the beginning of a cup pattern, a reverse cup pattern, right? One that's pushing the stock, or the in this case the future, down in price. So what I want to see initially before I start to build a position is I want to see the gold futures break this 180 SMA resistance, guys, or support rather. I want to see them break the support, because that's going to be showing more downside, more potential to push down back into the 1260 range, the low 1270 range, and maybe into the 1250 range. And obviously, you know, judging off this chart, we have to understand that JDST is starting to make a nice cup pattern, right? The cup pattern that's pushing to the upside rather than the downside, because obviously whenever, you know, gold futures are pushing down, making a cup pattern to the downside, that is when JDST is making that cup pattern to the upside. So we have a nice little, cup pattern here We have an alert set at $52 to see if it does end up pulling back there, but I don't even think it's going to pull back to $52, to be quite frank with you all. So I'm just going to replace this, put it at around $53.80, see if we do end up pulling back. And if we do end up pulling back a bit, that could open up a nice entry point since we are a bit overbought right now on JDST, so I don't want to force anything, but my eyes are peeled, guys. I'm watching this one for the right entry point, JDST, and I do see potential, guys, from $53, $54 up to at least the previous resistance at around $58, which would put us at this previous support, which is obviously a new resistance since we broke below it, and putting us also at that 180 SMA resistance. So, you know, it's safe to say that I think JDST has around 6-7% potential for profit. So that's what I'm looking at in terms of JDST, guys. So JDST, UWT, and JNJ are three stocks / ETFs that are uptrending right now that I am watching. So I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little video. Feel free to smash that like button, leave a comment, subscribe. I'll catch you all in the video later on today. Have a great day, guys. Peace out.